Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Dragon Trail, Hunter World on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Dragon Trail, Hunter World and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5. Which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Dragon Trail, Hunter World. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else folks, the first thing to do is to launch our main browser. We open the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to that URL that I have highlighted in green color. Now, you are able to see on the PC screen. You don't need to type this URL, simply because there's the link in the video description and the first main comment. We ended up here on the site of Usitility, at which we find here a precise demonstration on how to obtain Dragon Trail, Hunter World on laptop or computer. We search down a little bit and then click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on the link, we get to the site of BlueStacks. No panic, it is simply the Android emulator that we are going to use to get access to this game Dragon Trail, Hunter World on PC. As you can see from here we access several advantages of using the emulator. So we will proceed to download the Dragon Trail, Hunter World by simply clicking on this button play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green. The step is clicking on this button. Of course, the download action starts and ends immediately. Voila, here is located the download. It is an executable file. The following step is to launch the executable file, so we click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make changes to the laptop or device. We have clicked yes. I minimize the browser to view the installation software considerably better. The installation software is pretty simple. It includes a couple of possibilities, install and setup path. I will describe what setup path genuinely does. We simply click it, and therefore we see that we have now here the path where the emulator can be set up. If we would like to change for better this directory we need to click on that browse option, so we select another directory and install the emulator precisely where we like. To keep it simple, just set it where it is. I click on back, therefore I simply click on install. Fantastic. The installation begins and it is going to progress in the download of those MB that are shown on our computer screen. The moment you download it, it may be more or less MB. The data transfer rate can be at a higher speed or at a lower speed, depending on your internet and according to the speed of the emulator web servers. Today they're going extremely fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At present, the emulator has been launched successfully. As you can discover, down here, there's a progress bar which will move forward to the right and once it actually reaches the ending, the emulator will be launched for the first time. Indeed, the emulator has already been launched, there for the very first time. Before we keep going, as you can discover, it made a couple of app icons there on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon is the one we're concerned about. At any time when we are planning to run Dragon Trail, Hunter World on our laptop or computer, we twice mouse click on that app icon and launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Shall we do the following step, which is actually a must-have, and this is to begin browsing the Google Play Store. And we are going to click on Play Store. As you can view the Google Play is launched. Right here we are required to log on. So now when we are on this page, we must absolutely execute the next phase which is obligatory. Therefore mouse click on Sign In. Presently it says, Checking Info. It may once in a while get stopped at checking info, that's why it doesn't continue. In this case, you can try to connect to your account after a number of hours it's going to most likely be sorted out. At this time we are going to insert our email address and password. The email address needs to be a Gmail email and its related password. As an example you make use of the same exact email you are using right now in your own YouTube account. Then I will type in my details and I will come back after I have done it. Voila, data inserted. Discover Google welcoming us and presenting us their terms of service. We must accept all of them by just clicking, I agree. Following that, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You can also keep it selected and it'll generate a backup of the data files on that device to Google Drive. I won't check it, you can make use of this option if you wish. We just click on accept. Google Play, formerly Android Market, is launched automatically and completely on its own. To set up the application, we must get to the emulator desktop by left-clicking the app icon indicated in green. At present that we are on the desktop of this emulator for Android, we can see that we find right here the Install App Game button. We mouse click on this button. Listed here we have the video game. Let's mouse click now on the Install option that I'm just highlighting now in green. That click will start the setup. Straight away it is going to download and install the Android game. It may take some time or perhaps it may possibly be amazingly quickly. It all will depend on our connection to the web. This has by then ended setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by hitting this particular option I'm emphasizing in green, so that you can use Dragon Trail, Hunter World for the first time. You are by now on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're on the way to just click that fresh Dragon Trail, Hunter World icon that's been provided. Your game is launched for the first time. Here we end up with it. I could mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to comment on the volume level of that emulator. This is right here. We have got the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume. This way we won't use the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of the emulator. And also to enjoy the experience to the max, we will activate the large monitor, for which we have two alternatives. This one is the first one. We mouse click on that app icon that I'm pointing out in green. Thus, the screen is maximized, coming with one border on top, one at the right and the third one at the bottom. Granted that we desire to have fun with the application using all the screen, we mouse click on this particular software icon. And we might at present be experiencing and enjoying the gameplay in 100% screen setting. To stop the full screen setting, just click the F11 key. And we'd at present play in standard display screen mode. At present, I am going to demonstrate to you the computer keys mapping and that is certainly quite cool. This means we definitely will be ready to operate the game more easily. The first task is to press this application icon. It's now time to get the recommended setups. I'll go ahead and keep the normal configuration, however if you plan to improve this, you can also do it without any problem. Obviously, the emulator is completely in our language. Once in a while it occurs that your emulator is started in the erroneous language, for example, in Chinese language. And as a consequence to set it in the correct language we click here to the cogwheel. And thus here inside of many other configuration settings, we just click the language drop down. We may go with the language we want, Spanish, Mandarin, and so forth. As soon as the language is chosen, we would save, the emulator would reboot, as well as the game application, next time we use it, would also be in the specified language. So now, there is another element that we have to take into consideration, and this is that we will receive a message from Google saying that a brand new electronic device has been connected with this Google account. It should ask us if we are the individuals who have associated with that electronic device. That's right, we may not worry, because the emulator is acting as an Android electronic device. So you can see which electronic device is currently being emulated, we visit right here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. Let's go here to the model choice. And now we realize that the emulator is simulating a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for that video user demo. I hope that you appreciated it, particularly that everyone found it helpful. If that is so, bring it a superb like, subscribe to the channel, and if you have feedback, requests or ideas, put them in the comment area below. You can also comment things on my Twitch channel, I do live streams every now and then, you get it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Simply click on any of these online videos that are showing up on the screen and let's have fun again in the future video game videos. Bye.